Morning, everybody. I just want to address you first. I want to thank you for all the messages that I've received and things like that. What happened to you yesterday was very scary. And I don't want you for 1 minute to think that I'm some superhero or Greg Howard. What I did was out of a reaction to something I saw that it was unbelievable. It was almost surreal and like a movie to me. I never thought that would happen in our school, just like many of you have stated. I saw someone that I care very deeply about in danger, and my body took over. I'm not one who's very emotional very often. I don't like to do that, but I want you guys to know this. This was something that it is, Dr. Lein's word was aberration. And you know how his vocabulary is, but I actually know that. The thing that I don't hear very much yet is, I want you guys, when you're saying prayers for everybody involved, don't forget the young man who was involved. Okay? He didn't know this was something he was going to do. They need prayers just like we do. You guys are safe here. You guys are safe here, and we work to have that happen every day. If you take anything out of this, you look around this room right now of 800 plus people, you have an opportunity here to make a change in this building of being kind to one another, accepting people who might be a little bit different than you. If you see someone sitting by themselves, talk to them, that kind of thing. I'm very glad to see every one of your smiling faces here this morning. Please, like I said, don't think of me as a hero. Maybe what I did in hindsight was heroic. There's a lot of people who choose to put themselves in harm's way. Those policemen you saw, military people, firemen, those guys signed up to be in situations like we were put in yesterday. Mine was more of a reaction. Like I said, in hindsight, probably what I did was heroic. That doesn't make me a hero. I guess if you're in your eyes, I am. That's yours. But I want you to know, every one of these staff members deeply cares about you. You use the word love a lot. It's used probably when it should be, or it shouldn't be sometimes. But love is a deep caring for someone. And in this case, I love you all, and so do your classmates, and so do your staff members. So when you think about what happened yesterday, think about love. Now, I'm not talking about romantic love, I'm talking about deep care. Care for each other, take care of one another, and like I said, I don't like to show my emotion, but I'm just very glad to be here today and see all of you and have this end the way it did. So I appreciate and love every one of you, and thank you.
And so are you. And you can't imagine how that makes me feel. I want you to know you are safe. And you always have been. And this was just one troubled young man. It's not an indication of what we know is in the hearts of all of you in this room today. I want you to direct your prayers to the troubled young man and his family. You gotta forgive. You know, it is what we must do because we rise when our energy to help those most in need shows. This family bears a terrible burden. I want you to please keep them in your thoughts and keep them in your prayers. Let's help them in the field. Mr. Rollinger, Mr. Shearing, Mr. Vickers, and the entire staff and teachers, you guys know they're heroes every day. It's just it took this to show everybody else.